Good morning, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Please give me a like button so I know that you are here. And I'm Lucia Chavez, Chief Nutritionist at Obesity Control Center. And it's really a pleasure to be in contact with you guys. So I do appreciate your questions. I appreciate your comments, your input. So feel free to do so. I'm going to be talking about the carb flu. So what is the carb flu? It is the process in which your body is going to be switching from stimulants such as sugar and caffeine into nutrition. So we need to change the metabolic source of energy. And that does create havoc. Some of the symptoms are fatigue and joint pain and feeling moody and having lethargy, of course. So going through the carb flu is no fun. I get it, but you have to go through it. And the last thing you want is to go through that while in the recovery process. So that's what the pre-op is for, to help you get away or clear out the carbs, get away from the abstinence syndrome or symptoms, and to, of course, get ready for the surgery. You need to replenish nutrients before the surgery so that you have a better recovery. And, of course, to lose some weight and to be able to clean up the liver. So we have many purposes while on the pre-op, but one of those is to make sure that you go through the carb flu before the surgery, not after. So to help you guys with the symptoms, to get rid of those symptoms, you would need to, number one, drink some broth. Broth has minerals, and the symptoms from carb withdrawal do come from mineral deficiencies. So once you pull off the stimulants, you do get the energy that you have from nutrition. And if there's nothing there, then, of course, you're going to be lacking energy and feeling horrible. So do drink some broth. Don't worry about the sodium. Of course, if you're purchasing that, then it should be low sodium. But if you're making that at home, which I'm hoping you are, then you don't need to worry about the sodium. Thank you, Roxanne, for being here. Pollyanna, hello. Hi there, Gabby. Thank you for being here. Oh, it's so good to have you guys here. All right, so also drink more water and drink electrolytes. That is important. That is major. If you don't follow my recommendations, guess what? You're going to suffer. So I don't want you to suffer. I'm also going to be posting in here, once we're done with the live video, we're going to be posting an infographic on what to do with a carb flu. But I just want to emphasize that electrolytes are important. So, but I don't want you to purchase the Gatorades or Pedialytes or those that you find at the pharmacy. Those are high in sugar. They are also high in flavorings and colorings. And remember them, flavorings and colorings kill the good bacteria at the gut. And you want that good bacteria to be thriving in the gut during the recovery process because you don't want to be at risk of infections, right? And the good bacteria do help with that. So no colorings, no flavorings, no sugar while in the pre-op, and that includes the electrolytes. So what can you include? I usually send you guys a link to the electrolytes I recommend. So those are just some drops that you add to your water. You can add that to your broth, to any drinks that you're having, even to your Vitalift shake. You just put the drops in there and that's it. You will notice the difference, all right? Another thing to do will be to eat more carbs. I mean, gosh, what did I just say? More fats, 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 fats. You need fats. You need to make sure that you feel satiety and that you are enhancing the flavor of vegetables. That's what you use the fats for. You know that while on the pre-op, you need to be eating a lot of vegetables, right? But if you don't add fats, if they are, you know, lame, then you're not going to be enjoying those vegetables. So yes, you can use bacon, but the right way to use the bacon is to give flavor to the Brussels sprouts. And yes, you can use cheese while in the pre-op, but the purpose of that cheese is to give flavor to, say, some portobello that you put into the oven. So the use of fat, of fats in your diet has a purpose, and the purpose is to enhance the flavor of food. Fats also carry some vitamins and antioxidants, so they do matter while in the pre-op. Just don't overdo it and use them to give flavor again to the vegetables. But you need those fats to get rid of the carb flu. The carb flu lasts no longer than 10 days. It really depends on your addiction. So you will go through this abstinence syndrome, and hopefully it will only last 5 days. Keep in mind that in the carb flu, when things come to having very strong cravings for sugars, that you feel really, really bad, you have doubts that you are doing this right because you don't think that you can do this for life. Nobody can do that for life. Nobody can feel horrible for life. It's only 5 days. But at the worst moment is when your body is going to be switching to the metabolic pathway of nutrition and fats. So it's just a matter of holding on just a few more days. If you give in, then you're just going to go back to square one with the abstinence syndrome. So that means that you will only prolong the torture. So just know that at some point that won't continue to happen. And pretty much the next day, you will feel the difference. You will feel the energy coming from nutrition. You are going to feel the clarity of mind. I mean, the sustainable energy is just different. And hunger goes down and cravings go down. So it's just like a kid having a tantrum, you know? It's just like a kid that wants to have the lollipop. So if you give in, saying, okay, just one lick, you know, then what is going to happen with the kid? It's just going to have worse tantrums every time because the kid will know that you give in, right? So one bite of bread or one sip of soda will get you back into day one of the carb flu. So hold on, be strong, you can do this. Eat many, many, many vegetables, have your electrolytes, have your broth, include the fats, and that's going to minimize all the symptoms. Can you relate to this? Give me a thumbs up so I know if you went through the carb flu, if you're going through that, if you heard about it, okay? So give me those thumbs so I'll know where you're at. And remember, there is a strategy for this situation not to be prolonged. We don't want you to be in torture. But you will change your life in pretty much 7 to 10 days because your body is going to be feeling completely different, all right? Sugar and caffeine are just stimulants. So yeah, they help you go by. They help you with your day. But in reality, if you don't have any nutrition, you're just going to be having those highs and those lows. And when you hit the lows, they are pretty bad, right? Gabby, yeah, carb flu is temporary. You got it. Stay the course. Don't give in to cravings during this period. It will finish sometime soon. So hopefully by knowing this, you understand that it's just a process. It's the first step, and it's probably the hardest, okay? But once you're done with that, then you can move on into a better place. And that can still happen in the pre-op. And imagine how is it going to be after the surgery. So that's when you start changing your life, okay? Keep in mind that we are here to help you out, that we are here to help you manage the pre-op. We know that things have to be done differently, and you may not know how to do that. So we do expect you guys to be in contact with us, all right? Well, if you have any questions, make sure to post them. I'm right here for you, or you can just send me an email. Of course, you can watch this video at a later time. And if you think that this message or this information is important, then please tag someone so they'll know that they can be seeing this and feel better while in the pre-op, okay? Well, guys, it's been a pleasure being with you. I'm going to be here every third Thursday of the month. If you have any subjects that you want me to cover, feel free to post those here too as well. So then I'll make sure to answer those questions, all right? Thank you for being here. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.